Hi, and welcome to the Blue Player. Now, this is not a review video. This is going to be me actually just playing the game. Now, I'm not going to run through all of the rules in the game, but I am going to give a brief overview on how the game works. Now, the game that we're going to be playing today is At the Gates of Loyang. Now, this is a Uwe Rosenberg game, and it does play 1 to 4 players. Today, we're going to be playing the solo variant, so I'm going to take you through the changes of that as well. Now this game is played over 9 rounds, and each round consists of 3 phases. Now the first phase is the harvest phase. In the harvest phase, players will be bringing in crops and putting out a new field. Following that, you'll have the card phase, where players will each get action cards and they're played out. And in a multiplayer game, a new starting player will be chosen. And then there's the action phase, which we'll go through a little bit here in just a second. So for the purposes of this game, we're going to assume that I haven't done this just yet. This was a solo change, and we'll do it, but I'm going to choose which vegetable to start into my home field. Now, in the case of this, I have decided I am going to use pumpkin. So I take one pumpkin from my shop, and I take the rest of the pumpkins, and I fill in this entire thing. Okay, now that I've got all my pumpkins in there, we're good to go on that. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go through the actions that a player can take on their turn before going into what these are over here for the solo game. So on a turn, a player may sow a vegetable as seed. In order to do that, they take one vegetable from their cart and they plant it into a field and pull from the supply and get some more fields, vegetables. The other thing they can do is buy vegetables from their shop, and that's going to be the darker number here. You can buy it, put it over here, and now it's available for you to use. You can also sell to your shop as another action, so you can sell from here back to here, but you're going to do so with the number in the lighter amount. You can trade vegetables at market stalls. Now, market stalls are these right here, and they have different vegetables on them that you can trade at either a 1 or 2 to 1 ratio. Another thing that you can do is to play or discard a helper. Now, these are cards like this, which allow you to get a action that you can take in order to use the helper. You can deliver to a regular customer. Now, regular customers are these here, and they would be here. And you can, like, for example, this one here needs a pumpkin and a wheat, and in which case I would deliver to him. You can also deliver to a casual customer, and that is the ones that would come down here, and they just have something they want once, and they'll pay an amount of money depending on what you've done. Another action you can take is what's called to buy a 2-pack. Now, buy a 2-pack just gives you 2 random cards off the top of the draw pile, and that will cost you a value. Depending if you have any market stalls or helpers, then you'll pay them whatever you have the most of there. So if I had 3 helpers, 2 stalls, I would pay 3. If I had 1 stall, no helpers, then I'm going to pay 1. If I have nothing, then it is a free action. Now, when you buy one of those, you have the choice to keep 1, 2, or none of the cards. If you keep 2 of them, you actually select 1 to be the top and 1 to be on the bottom, and you put it in the space for the top card. You won't get access to the second card until the first one is removed. If you take 1, then you just put it in its place and you discard the other one. If you take none, obviously you discard both of them. At the end of each round, then the player will need to store vegetables. And by default, any vegetables you have here, you can only store 1. You can spend at any point 4. You can spend 2 money to upgrade this to be able to hold 4. And then after that comes the scoring phase, which is the only way to get points in this game. And it's this little track right here. And what happens is first you can spend one money to advance one spot. And you can do that once in each round. Anything else is you have to spend the money that is on the track. So I spent this one to move from the to here. But then if I wanted to move to the three, it would cost me three. And if I had four more coins, I could spend four to go up, etc. So you can see you're always, as long as you've got one coin, you can always get one up. But you're going to want money to move forward as the game progresses. Another thing in this game that you can do is take a loan. Now, taking a loan gives you immediately five money, but you can never repay this. And at the end of the game, each loan you have will set you back one on the scoring track. Now, loans are not a bad thing, and some people will hesitate to take these, when in fact, I actually think that this is an effective path towards victory. Sometimes you just need to do it. The game ends after nine rounds, and that is triggered right here. You can see when everyone harvests or anyone harvests their last vegetable, that would be round nine from this home field. One thing to note about fields, except for the home field, which triggers any other, if you ever pull the last vegetable off of it, that field is removed from the game. Okay, so now what I want to do is note something that's different with the solo game. In the solo game, you have over here these cards, and this is taking the place of the normal normal distribution of cards, where normally there would be this sort of back and forth drafting. That doesn't take place in the solo game. In addition, you will notice that I have some cards laid out here. And these cards are laid out to simulate a few cards from a dummy player. So the dummy player actually has two market stalls, two casual customers, and two regular customers. Now I'm gonna go ahead and seed out the market stalls for the casual customer. And now we have those market stalls seeded. So that will allow us to have some interaction in the solo game that would normally be present in a multiplayer game that isn't present without someone else at the table. Now over here, as I said, this replaces the normal distribution. And the way this works is I have these three columns, but it's really about the rows. And so when I go to the distribution and I need to take two cards, I could take cards from this top row and it will cost me nothing. I can take from the second row, but it will cost me one coin. And I can take from either of these rows, but it will cost me two coins. At the end of the distribution, anything in the second row here will be discarded and everything else will move up, filling in the bottom. All right, so the last things to mention is a little setup thing and then just something about the customers themselves. So in setup, you actually give each player their own private deck field, and this consists of two decks of four cards of each field type. There are three, four, five, and six in terms of the amount of vegetables it will hold, and each one of these can have different types of vegetables, which we'll see as they come out. And you shuffle each of those separately and then put one on top of the other. Serving a customer. Once I have a regular customer added into my space, I am required to serve it. So initially, I will place one of these little purple double-sided happiness tokens on it, right here. And as long as each round I give the customer the two vegetables they're looking for, then I get my money and everyone's happy. But if there's a round that I can't deliver on it, then I flip this over and now they are an unsatisfied, angry customer. If they're angry and I can't fulfill their order on another round, then I have to pay them two money. And that will continue each time until I have fulfilled their order and completed the entire card. At any point, once I've done everything, then that card does come out of my play area and is discarded. Casual customers, on the other hand, have no penalties for not fulfilling them. However, they just sit there and accumulate, and their payout is based on how many I have in relation to my regular customers. If at the time that I were to fill this order, I had one casual and one regular, then that would mean that this guy pays out seven when I fill his order. But if I had two, so I had more regulars than casuals, then he will pay an additional two coins. If, on the other hand, I had less casual customer, regular customers than casual customers, he will actually pay me two less. So the last thing to do before we get going is I'm going to take my starting money, which is 10 coins. One last thing I'm sorry to note during the solo game that's different is the discard pile. The discard pile is only shuffled the first time I remove a field because it has been emptied. Otherwise, it actually just continues. In the solo game, our objective is to try to get 17 on the score tracker in order to effectively win the game, and then we can judge our victory from there. Okay, so I'm gonna start playing, and I will talk to you as I play as to what I'm doing. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm going to flip over a private field and add it to my area here, and I'm going to harvest one pumpkin. That is all I can harvest since it is the first round of the game. And this new field holds up to five if I plant in it, and it can hold wheat, pumpkins, radishes, or cabbages. From here, I'm now going to move into the distribution phase. In the solo game, that means searching for selecting a card from here. So I want something that I think I could fulfill or something that could maybe help me out. So if I look in this one, I have this made, and then this one allows me to do vegetables at a 1-to-1, so maybe not the greatest thing just yet. I could attempt to work on this customer here. This one allows me to turn satisfaction, so that's not really useful. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm gonna take this card for this market stall, and this card is for free and it will go here. And I'm gonna take this casual customer and put it in here. What I'm looking at is I have the ability to get pumpkins already. I'm probably gonna trade and try to get some of those radishes. So we'll see how that works out. But now this column completely is discarded and all of these cards move up. And we fill in the empty spaces. So now I'm in the main portion of the game where I will get to do all of my actions. So as I said before, let me seed this real quick. You do seed your markets when you get them, because once you've traded for the vegetables that it has, that card does go away. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to trade this pumpkin out for this radish. And then I'm going to plant this radish here. And that will fill that in. And so I'll be able to harvest radishes on the next turn. I have no other vegetables. I could buy vegetables, but I'm not going to be able to plant them, so there's no point in me doing so. I could buy a two-pack, and I think I'm going to. So I have one here, so it's going to cost me one. And I buy two cards. And we have a field, a common field. Now, one thing about fields, when you get them from the common deck, is they do have a two cost to bring them into play. And we have a customer, and I think I'm going to keep this customer, and I'll show you why in a little bit, but I don't think I want this field just yet. So I'm going to discard the field and there's really nothing else I can do this particular round. So I'm going to spend my one coin to move up one space, and I think I'm going to go ahead and spend the three coins to move up an additional space. I'll still have five coins, so it's not that big of a deal at this point. So from here, we're going to move to the next round. So the first thing we'll do is we'll harvest. And I will bring out another field. And now I'll do the distribution phase. Now this is interesting. If I could plant this here, I could guarantee myself that. That is interesting. You know what? It's going to mess up my plan for my casual customers, but I think I'm going to do it. So this card will cost me nothing. I think I'm going to take this market woman, and she allows me to exchange one of my market stalls for another player's market stalls and then refill them both. So we're going to put that there, but that will cost me two coins. So I'll take my two coins, or to change. We will remove this column. All of these will move up, and we will fill in the remaining spaces. Okay, and now we will begin again. Now, as I said, this guy here, he starts out happy. If I do not give him two radishes this turn, then he is going to be unhappy. And sometimes it's okay to let them be unhappy. And because I'm actually going to plant this radish. And the reason is although it will make him unhappy this round, the first time you make him unhappy, you don't have to pay him. And now I've guaranteed 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. I've guaranteed over four rounds to be able to make him happy. So I'm giving up that I'm going to make him unhappy this round. Now I do have a pumpkin, but I don't know that I have any use for that pumpkin just yet. But I tell you what I am gonna do. No, I'm gonna keep the pumpkin. I don't see anything. But I am going to go ahead and buy another two-pack, which will cost me one coin. And maybe we'll get lucky. So we have another market stall that we could bring out here. And we have this guy here who wants radishes and cabbage. Now, I think I'm going to keep them both, and I'm going to take the market stall, and I'm going to bring it out. Now, as I said, I choose in a two-pack which one that I want to be on the top. If at any point this market stall ever goes away, then at that point this card will come out. Now, I could also have played it like this, but I think right now that would not be a good idea. So we'll put this out here, and we will fill it in. We'll get our radish and our leek. Okay, so now we're at the end of the round. I don't really have anything else I can do. As you can see, some of the early rounds in this game will go a little slower, and you'll start to build up from there. So I do need to store this pumpkin, and I can currently store one. I will spend one coin to move up one on the track. I don't have enough to move up any further, and now we will begin another round. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to harvest. And that also brings anything we had storage back into our cart. Then we're going to bring out another field, which is good. And now we're going to do our distribution. Now this is an interesting card here, the Con Man. The Con Man normally allows you to swap one of your helpers with someone else's helper. But in the solo game, it actually allows you to swap this helper with another helper in the offer. So if I bought this for one, I could trade it later for this one. And so I can think about once only buy two vegetables of the same kind in your shop for the price of one. So that would allow me to, say, buy two wheat here for three as opposed to six. I think I'm going to take the con man for one. Only because I want the haggler, I think. So I'm gonna do that so I could all do the haggler. And so one thing I didn't mention is I don't have to buy two cards. I could just buy the one, and I think I'm going to do that for the time being. So these cards will go away, and these cards will move up. And we will fill this in. Oh, and the last round, I actually forgot to flip this token over to the angry side because we did not fulfill his order. Okay, so we've done our distribution phase, and now it's time to figure out what we're going to do. Now, I do have the two radishes, and right off the bat, I'm going to go ahead and fulfill the order that this guy wants, which will get me 5 coins. So I'll take in my 5. And I have 2 pumpkins here, which doesn't fill anything that I needed, but if I look over here, like for example, this guy wants a pumpkin, a radish, and a leek. Well, I do currently have the option to trade for a leek, and in fact, I'm going to do that. So I'm going to trade this pumpkin to get a leek, but I still need a radish. Now, the easiest way to get a radish is to buy it from the market. But in this case, it cost me 5, and I do have an option to trade here for 1 of them. So I'm going to spend 3 to buy a wheat, and then I'm going to take that wheat and trade it here for the radish. And now I have everything this person wants. I have a pumpkin, a radish, and a leek. Now, he pays 10, but as I said in the beginning, if I have more casuals than regular, then he will pay 2 less, which means he will only pay me 8. But that's okay because I was expecting that. So this customer is completed. And we will discard this one. Now, earlier we had this exchange market stalls, and I kind of like the idea of actually waiting because I think I still want that cabbage before I try to do that. Because I know that I've got this one underneath here that's going to cause cabbage to come out. Now, this wouldn't be a bad idea, but I don't have the cabbage coming just yet. So the last thing I need to think about is whether or not I want to try to plant in this field. And I think I'm going to actually do that. So I'm going to spend 3 coins. I'm going to buy this wheat. And then I'm going to plant this wheat. All right. And I think that's going to do it for this round, other than if I had anything to store, and I don't. I'll spend 1 coin to move up to the 5. And 6 coins to move up to 6. Now, one thing to keep, I always say when I'm teaching this game is don't be afraid to spend all of your money every round. And in fact, unless you have a plan for it, that you're going to need it, I recommend use as much money as you can. All right, and moving into the next round. So what we're gonna do is, again, we're gonna harvest. I'm gonna bring out a new field, which will be the 6. I may have to start moving some fields down the side, but that'll be okay. And I'm gonna look at my distribution here. I don't really like anything, but I kind of need something. So I think what I'm gonna do, I would really like to get some cabbages, but I really don't have the option to get them just yet. Other than right here. So I think I'm gonna, you know what? I'm gonna take a risk. I'm gonna take this for free. And I'm going to take this market stall. Wait, I can't take that market stall. I don't have any money. So I think we're not going to take any of their cards. We're going to get rid of this, move everything up. All right, and now we're going to begin. Now, the first thing I do want to do is look over here and see, because I still have this con man, and see if there's anything I want to do. Okay, so this will be interesting. So I'm actually going to take this con man, and this will allow me to swap this, bring the con man here, and bring this plow man here. And I'll explain in a minute why I'm going to do this. So from there, I'm going to fulfill this order, since I already know I'm going to do that. And that will get me 6 coins. Then I'm going to take this, which this allows me to return all vegetables from one of my fields that has at least 2 to the supply. So we're going to return these wheats to the supply. And this allows me to actually re-sow the field, which is what I was trying to do. And it doesn't allow you to do anything in the home. So this card gets discarded. And the reason I'm doing this is because I want to get cabbage planted for this. And I couldn't plant cabbage in this new one. So I'm going to take this pumpkin and I'm going to trade it here for this cabbage. And then we're going to plant the cabbage here. I'm sure there's people watching this right now who think that this was probably a crazy move, but I'm okay with it. And then I'm going to take the wheat and plant it here. Now, this is going to leave me a cabbage short when it comes around time for this, but I think there's a way that we can compensate for that. The last thing I am going to do is do this market woman here to exchange. So I'm going to take this stall and exchange it out for this one. And then this one will go here, and it does get refilled per the card. So in a multiplayer game, I might think about what I'm doing because I may be handing them a cabbage or a radish that they would not have gotten otherwise. Well, the radish, but the cabbage. So this card's discarded now. And we've refilled this one. Now, had we done this one, we would have had to bring this out. And I would like to avoid doing that until I'm ready for it. Can't fulfill any orders. We have a little bit of money, and we could do a buy, a blind pack, which would cost us 2. And given that I'm not going to be able to go up any further, I think I'm actually going to do that. So it's going to cost me 2 to buy the blind pack. And I'm going to bring out 2 cards. This one allows me that I can... Now, normally you can only deliver to one of your customers once per round, so I can only do this line or this line. You know, I can't do both of them on one card. This one would allow me to do it if I could. And then this is obviously another market, of which this actually would probably be pretty good because it would give me the ability to get that extra cabbage that I was worried about. So I think I am going to take that one, and I think I'm not going to take this. All right, so I'm okay with that. I can't deliver to this person, so I'm going to make them angry. I should have had a thing there already, but I knew that that was going to happen, so we're okay with it. All right, and that's going to end that round. I'll spend 1 coin to move forward. And it's going to leave us 4, which isn't enough, so we'll move into the next round. All right, so next round, we're going to harvest from each of our fields. Bring out a new field. And look at the distribution again. Now, not really crazy about any of these, but there are a few things that aren't bad. I am going to take this haggler for 1 coin. He allows me to once only buy 2 vegetables of the same kind in my shop. I think we've already covered what he does earlier, so I'm going to take him, and he's not going to impact my blind cost, so I'm okay with that. And he cost me 1 coin. And I'm going to See, I want to take this, but I don't think it's in my benefit. But I haven't really, beans aren't really something that I've messed with, but I do have the option to get them. I just don't have the option to plant them. But this card will still be there. I don't really like anything else. So I think I'm just going to stick with the one card. So these will get discarded. These will all move up. All right, so from there, now I do need to remember that I have to take care of this customer and I have to take care of this customer. So right off the bat, I'm going to deliver to them. I don't want to accidentally forget about it. So he will pay me 6. And she will pay me 4. I'll just make change. Okay. Now, one thing to keep in mind with the shop is you can only buy what's there. So you have the ability to sell to it and things like that. But so like if I wanted to buy 2 wheat, I couldn't because there's only 1 wheat available in the shop. But it doesn't matter because I have plenty of ways to trade for it. So I'm not seeing anything I can do with the pumpkin yet. I am going to want to get some radishes. So I think I'm, and I have the ability to plant them, and maybe I'll go radish heavy. So I think I'm going to trade this out. Although I could try for that bean. No, I think I'm going to trade this out for the radish. And that means I will plant the radish. I don't think I've ever planted this many radishes before. All right, so now we have a field full of radishes. There's nothing really else for me to do. Like I said, I could buy from the shop, and that maybe wouldn't be a terrible idea. I could try to clear out. Now, you can't just discard these. These you're allowed to just discard without using. I would have to find some way to trade. I'm not sure that I want, until I get the ability to plant more cabbage, I don't think I want that to come out. Hopefully our next field out there will have cabbages. So I think that's going to be it for this. I have nothing to do as far as that. I'm going to spend 1 coin to move up to 8. And it would cost me 9 to move up, and I will do that. So I move up to 9. And we'll begin another round. Okay, so we begin again. I will bring a pumpkin, a radish, a cabbage, and a radish. Now, these 2 fields have been emptied, and I didn't do anything special, so they will be discarded from the game. I'm just going to go ahead and slide these over. Guess I don't need to go down the side. And we will bring out a new one. Perfect. It allows me to plant cabbages. And that is something I was definitely looking for. So now we're going to look over here. And I don't really have any reason for this card. A market stall at this point is not really helpful. I still can't get leeks at the moment, so I'm not sure that that's going to help us. We could use this to trade for multiple leeks. This one here allows us to trade one of our casual customer for someone else's casual customers. And I don't think that's actually a bad idea. Because if I look over here, because I know that I'm going to be spending 2 of these and these 2. And that's what I'm going to have left, right? And I could do, well, it would cost me 5 to buy a radish, but only 3 to buy a wheat. I am going to lose 1, 2. I think it still makes me 1 coin. I'm just not sure how well that would work out for us. Well, maybe I could do this differently. I could probably buy the wheat. You know what? I'm just going to try it. So I'm going to take this one, which will cost me 2 coins. This is a 2-1. I think I'm not going to take another card. Normally, it's really weird. Normally, I don't take... normally, I don't skip taking a second card very often. I just haven't liked my options. Okay, so let's see if this works out for me. So, I'm going to go ahead and fulfill my orders. Well, let's not get hasty because I don't want this to go away. I need to do this in order. I'm going to fulfill this order first. And that's going to get me 5 coins. And the reason being is because what I want to do with this casual customer, when I fill it, I want this regular customer to still be in play. So I'm going to fill his order first so there's still more regular customers. But I'm not filling this guy specifically. So I'm going to pull this off here. And then I'm going to do this one, which allows me to exchange one of my casual customers for and one belonging to another. I'm going to exchange this one for this one. And this will come out. Oh, and one thing I forgot to do, and I should have done, is once my fields were emptied at the beginning of this round, before I filled this in, I should have reshuffled the discard pile. This is the one time it gets shuffled in the solo game. But given the cards are random, I don't think it's going to affect us too much. Okay, so back to that. So now we've done this, and we still need a wheat in order to fulfill this, and that would cost me 3 normally to do 1. But what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to use the haggler, and I'm going to use the haggler to buy 2 of something for the same price as 1. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to buy the 2 cabbages for 5. And the haggler will go away. Then I'm going to take one of the cabbages and I'm going to trade it out. I'm going to trade it here for the wheat. And the reason I'm doing that is because I know what's under there and I am actually ready for that customer to come out. So this card will go away and this customer will come out. We'll put a little happy token next to him and slide this over. Now I have what I need to fulfill this order. And actually, because of the way this worked, I could have fulfilled this order anyway. I forgot how we were going to do that. But, so we have the 3 items this guy wants. Now it's 7. We have more regulars, so he will pay us out 9. So 9 for him. We'll discard him. And now we'll go ahead and fulfill our original regular customer, who's going to pay us 7. And he will now come out of the game. We'll slide this over, and we have fulfilled this one. We haven't fulfilled this one. Now, we could buy for 5, and we would be able to go ahead and fulfill his order. But I don't like that. Again, I like the idea of going ahead if I need to and making him upset. Because if I make him upset, I'll be able to plant to guarantee myself the rest of it and take care of the other one that I'm going to need here. So I am going to anger him this round, and I'm going to plant this cabbage here. Now, had I not had the ability to plant this cabbage here, like if that field didn't allow cabbages, I might have considered doing this differently. We're planting cabbages. Okay, so I think that's it. I could do a blind buy for 2, but I don't think I want to in this case. Because I think it's going to cost me 1 to move forward, and then it's going to cost me 11 to move forward again. And then I still have a little bit of money here, which I'm okay with. And so I still have a few rounds to get up this track. Now, it's not looking good, but we'll see what happens. So we'll move into the next round. Next round, pumpkin, cabbage, wheat, radish, and cabbage. Now, this one has been emptied, so it comes out of the game. We will bring out a new one, which I'll go ahead and just put here. And we'll look over here. Now, one thing to notice, so I said we're going to look over here, and one thing to say is if you ever have any questions about these helper cards, the back of the book, the last few pages, does have a better explanation of each of the cards. So with the merchant, we could buy something that we need to deliver twice. In the case of this, we need to deliver this one twice, but we don't have any cabbage in our shop, so that's not an option. So the merchant's not something I would really want. We have the trader here that allows me to trade at a stall, but I don't really see anything there I want either. So I think what we're going to do is I'm going to buy this official for one coin, or two coins, sorry. And he allows me to take the two-pack for free in this round. And the reason I'm doing that is because I am going to also take this as well. And that would have made it three. So basically, it still costs me two. But I would like the option to trade for a radish if I need it. Again, this wasn't really a great move, but it was okay, basically. Okay. So we will throw these out, move everything up. We are getting close to the end, so I need to start thinking about maximizing my profits a lot more. Again, it's not looking great. All right, so the first thing I'm gonna do is go ahead and fulfill my orders here, just because I don't wanna forget. So I'm going to do that. And this is where if I'd had the option to do a twice, I would have really liked to have done that, but I couldn't. So that's going to get me six. I'm going to deliver to him for five. I'm going to use the official and take a two-pack for free. And I really like this one. This I don't think is going to serve us very well. We haven't really needed pumpkins, but I am going to take this casual customer, and I think if creative enough, we might actually be able to serve him fairly quickly. Or her, sorry. All right, so it's looking for a cabbage, a bean, and a leek. Now, all I currently have is this pumpkin. Now, I need to keep in mind this will pay 14, so how can I maximize this? Now, I can get the bean and I can get the leek. So I think I'm going to spend the three here to get a wheat. I'm going to trade the wheat out. This is where I'm going to get a little interesting because I just kind of want to get things out. So I'm going to trade this wheat for this wheat and then trade this wheat for the bean. So I can get this card out, because I don't think I'm going to need it anymore. And then I'm going to trade this pumpkin for... I like having that one, so I'm going to trade it out for the leek, I believe. Nope, I'm going to trade it out for the cabbage, because I do need more cabbage coming, and I currently don't have it. So I'm going to trade it out for the cabbage, and I'm going to plant the cabbage. It's not exactly what I wanted to do, but it's kind of what I need to do. We'll be able to fill this, but I think we're going to have to wait a little bit longer. So maybe I didn't need the bean just yet, but we'll see what happens. So I'm going to store the bean, and then I don't think I can make any more money. Maybe that wasn't the best move. Because it's going to cost us one to move up. Yeah, maybe we should have waited, but it is what it is. So I'm going to end up with a 10 surplus. So next round, we'll probably move a lot more. All right, so that's going to end that round, and we will begin again. So now we're going to go over to our distribution phase, and we're going to think about this a little careful. Let's see. I know that we're going to be using these And we're going to be using these. So we're going to have those, but I can get the leek. I can't get the cabbage. How can we get a cabbage is what I'm thinking. So I don't really like anything over here, to be honest. As much as it pains me, I think I'm not going to take a card. Again, those watching are probably like, I'm so bad at this game. But that's kind of the thing. Sometimes it works out, sometimes it doesn't. So let's move on. We're going to fill this order here and get our six. We know that this is going to go here, and we know we still need a cabbage somehow, and I can't buy a cabbage, so I think there's no way for me to get a cabbage currently without costing this. So we can't fill this order, and I can't upset this customer, so we're going to go ahead and fill this order, which will get us seven. And now this customer will come off. We'll put this one back here. So I would like to try to get another customer here if I can. I really would like some way to get a cabbage. We could try a blind buy because we're only going to need one and then 13 to move up. So we're going to have leftover money no matter how we look at it. So let's go ahead and do a blind buy. It'll cost us two. Oh, eight. We forgot to fill this in. So these are going to go here. And now we'll do our blind buy. Well, this gives us a cabbage, but I don't know that. Actually, you know what? It will help us in the next round. So we're going to take this one. This one is not really going to do anything for us. So we're not going to take the field, but we are going to take this. Which will get us this and a cabbage and a leek. I wouldn't have done this other than I saw that I had this maid coming up, so I think we'll be okay there. We do still have the problem of not being able to store, so we're going to spend the two at this point because I really don't want to lose something, and I know I can't use it to upgrade this. So I can hold that extra vegetable. Well, you know what? Let's not do that. Spend that two back. I'm not going to do the upgrade. Why do the upgrade when I could do this and plant a bean? So we'll plant the bean since we know we're not going to use the bean till the next round anyway. We'll go ahead and plant it. All right, so it'll cost me one to move up to the 13. Messed that number up earlier. And then it will cost us 14 to go up another one. So in order to win this, we're going to need to go up three spots in the final round. So really going to need to make a lot of money. So let's see how this works out. So we're going to do the final harvest. And you notice I haven't taken a loan, which is very odd, to be honest with you. All right, so we'll look over here, and I already stated I was taking this maid because I know we're going to need it so that way we can do a two-for-one here. And I'm going to take this customer. Now, it's not necessarily that I even intend to fill it, but it's the last round, so even if I anger it, it doesn't matter. And this is the last round, so there's no reason to fill this back in. But you know what? I'm going to fill it back in anyway, only because somebody watching this might be playing along and they may have a con man here. And if they do, then it would need to be filled in. But if you don't have any reason to interact with these, then there's no reason to really fill them in. All right, so we will begin our last round. I will first fulfill an order here. And he will give me seven. I need a bean, a cabbage. And a leek. I think I may have, nope, this is still gonna work out, and it's an accident about how it's gonna work out. So I need a bean. I'm gonna trade a pumpkin for this leek. And I'm gonna use this, I'm gonna use this cabbage here. So this is a complete. Now this is 12, but it's a plus 2 because I have more. So that means I will get 14 for this particular one. And I'll take 15 and get change. So that will finish this customer off. So that's pretty good. Now I want to see about doing this. And this is actually what I said. This might actually work out when I didn't think it was going to. Because I need a leek and a cabbage. And if I use the maid, it says in this action phase, you may exchange vegetables 1-to-1 at market stalls where you would usually. So there's no limit. I can trade at 2 stalls where I would have to trade 2 for 1. So I can trade this wheat here for this leek. And I can trade this pumpkin here for this cabbage at a 1-to-1 because of the maid. That was perfect. So we will be able to fulfill this guy's order. He will give us 7. And the maid will go away. Now, if I look out here, I try to figure out, is there anything else I can do? I could do a blind buy, but I don't know that there's any way it's going to get me any money that's really going to help me. And it's going to cost me 3. So that's probably not a great strategy unless I had enough money minus 3 to go up anyway. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to think about this. So it's going to cost me 1 to move to the 15, and then I would need 16 to move from there, which means I'm going to end up with 13 left. So I'm going to be 4 short of trying to get to the victory. Now, in this case, that means I'm going to try. There's no reason for me not to go ahead and try. It's unlikely it's going to work out, but I'm going to spend the 3 coins. Because money means nothing at the end of this game. In fact, nothing but this track matters. I'm going to spend the 3 coins and take the blind buy. Who knows? Maybe I'll get something really, really awesome. And I got regular customers. And it doesn't look like I could probably make this work. I am still in the current round, so I'm still trading at a 1-to-1 no matter what. That would cost me 6, and then I could get a 9. Now I could net 2 off of that, but it cost me 3, and that would only be if I had had the wheat to do it to begin with. That would cost me 4. No. I can't do it. If I had some extra vegetables, I might be able to parlay just a little out of this. Sometimes you can squeeze a little bit, but I can't. So we're going to just do our final round. So our 1 coin to move up to the 15. And then our 16 coins to move up to 16. We do have 10 left, but we can't do anything with it. And that was the final round. All right, so there we go. As you can see, I ended up just shy. Still had 10 coins, but money does nothing in this game for us. So in the end, we have just been defeated. And that's okay. I mean, sometimes you get defeated at the gates of Loyang. I hope you guys have enjoyed this little solo playthrough. It's the first time doing it. I'm definitely going to try to do more of these. I know that the audio might have went up and down a little. It's my first time recording with the overhead camera, but I hope that this has given you guys an idea of how this game plays solo. I really, really, really enjoy this game solo. In fact, I think I kind of prefer this game solo, so there's that. With that said, I look forward to seeing you guys in the next episode, and take care.